Okay, assalamu alaikum everyone. Today we are going to start about our topic of transition elements. And in transition element, we also note that in our periodic table, it's shaped like this. If we just, it will go with the group 1, group 2, group 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And it will be transition element between the group 2 and group 3. Okay? Now, in transition element, first of all, we should know that what is the definition of transition element. That transition element are those elements which do have a one or more stable ions in it. For example, if you just talk about the iron, so iron do have a plus 2 and plus 3 ion to stable its electronic configuration. If we just compound it to the some other element. Okay. Now, there are also something about the electronic configuration. For example, if I am just going to write an electronic configuration of the iron, so iron has a mass of 28, sorry, atomic number 28, and atomic number 28, so it would be goes like 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, it would be 2, 4, 10, 12, 18, then 4s2, 20, and 3d8, it would be 28, okay? But it would be remain same for all of the elements except two elements in our syllabus. It's about the chromium and about the cobalt, I think. Okay, sorry, chromium. Chromium has a mass of 24, and let me check. It would be maybe copper. Talk about, I think. Yeah, it's copper. It's copper in our syllabus. We do have an exception in the electronic configuration. Okay. It has an atomic number of 29. If we're just writing with the chromium, so it would be like S1S2, 2S2, 2P6. 3s2, 3p6, okay, and then it would be like as after 3p6, it's a 100% demand that we should write 4s2, but we'll be writing 4s1, which is an exception in our syllabus, and then we are going to write it would be 3d5, okay. And so far for same as for copper, it would be like 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 2, 4, 10, 12, 18, and after 18 it would be 4s1 again, it would be 19, and then it would be 3d10. This is how we are going to fill about the copper 29. And if the question asks that what is a, you can say plus 2 configuration or plus 3 configuration, or sorry, plus 2 configuration of copper and chromium plus 3 configuration. So first of all, we need to remove about the this one, which is the more an outer shell. 1, then 2, 3, then 1, then 2, 3. Okay? Now, there's another thing in our syllabus is about the ligand. What basically is a ligand? Or there are two types of ligand in our syllabus, which are such as monodendrate ligands and another thing is about the bidendrate ligands. Okay, basically the ligand form during the complexes. For example, if any compound are formed, and for example, if you can say the copper is reacting with the plus 2 reacting with the water, okay, so it do form about the compound which is known as a copper, and includes in the bracket S2O, it would be 6, and the whole charge would be about the plus 2. You can, if you just are confusing that how we are going to write copper, water, 6 and S plus 2, you can just do by the help of that. If you know about that, if just for example, if a compound do have a charge, like Cu plus 2 is acting with the Cl minus. So it would be CuCl minus, and it would be then 4. Okay. Then we're just going to come back with the outermost shell, and we are going to bond it. So you will be knowing that how we can do this. Okay, but before that we need to discuss about the mode-ended and wide-ended ligands. Okay. Now, the mode-ended ligands, mono means one and bi means two, and it means that a species that do have a one lone pair, okay, and that each form a coordinate bond. They do have a one lone pair and they each form a coordinate bond, whereas a bi-ended ligand tells a species that contains two lone pair and they do form a coordinate and each form a coordinate bond. Okay. And now we are going to study about more things regarding ligand, the hardest structure, the geometry. But before that, I'm going to discuss about some of the possible questions, so that we'll be knowing that how the question comes and what is the proper way to memorize the question. Because there are always some things that do have a logic, and memorization is very much important in the chemistry. Now, I have a question regarding the, if for example, if there are two complex ions and they ask that the complex ion that why they are colored, okay, it of 2 marks why they are colored. And again, question they are asked about why they have different colors, okay, why they have different colors in it. They are the most common possible question. They do come usually in our paper, and this topic do have a almost 15-20 marks weightage in our 100 marks of P4 chemistry A-level paper. Okay, now the answer basically about that, explain why the two complex ions colored. It is because in a complex, the d orbital are split into two energy levels. In a complex, the d orbital are split into two energy levels, number one point. And number second point, the color is due to the absorption of the light in visible region. In visible region, color do absorb a light in it. So that's why it shows color. And the reason that why they have a different colors, okay? The number one point, that electron promotion to higher orbital absorb in photon. For example, the electron goes in the higher orbital, so they absorb a photon and then they give a different color. And another reason is that in the dd energy gap, in the dd orbital, which is known as the dd group, in the dd energy gap, there is a different, okay, the energy gap is different in where. So, yeah, we know if they are going with the to this one, it has a different gap. They are going to the this one, it has a different gap. They are going to the this one, it has a different gap. So it should add, they have a different gap. So hence, they do have a different colors when the complexes are going to form. Okay? This is how that we are going to remember about these things, and you can find in past papers that what are the more questions regarding memorization. And in the next video regarding transition element, we are going to cover about the colors, different colors, regarding the complexes and how the complexes form, and in the geometric structure of the complexes regarding 3D shape. Okay, till now, I'll have this.